Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today I'm going to show you how to install a drag chain to have DTF tubes more organized. So your tube will start like this and very easy to count when the printhead is moving. And finish like this, very neat and organized. The materials you're going to need today, you can go to bchtechnologies.com and just type in their name, for example, drag chain. However, I'm going to make a list of the material used in the description. So under the video, there is a description, and I'll put the list there. And also, I will try to put a link on the top right corner when I mention part. As for the printer, I'll use the IL-1800 as example. You can see the drag chain only bent to one direction. The other side is stiff. And also it has two ends. So let's take this upper end first. So it's really easy to snap it off, and then you can change directions and it snaps right back. So basically you bend it and you decide which one is up, which side is down. Then you can decide the direction of the end. If you look closely at the drag chain, you're going to see a little screwdriver symbol on one end. So in that end, I'm going to use a dental tool, just pry it up. And now you can take this digit out. This is how you make your drag chain longer or shorter. To put it on, you just do like how you install the end and press this plate down, and it's going to lock. We have this customer, the tube always get caught when the carriage is moving, so we're going to fix it today. This printer has a third-party bracket for the tubes, so we're going to remove this bracket first. Your printer may have a bracket that's going to work for the ends. But for this one, the bracket doesn't work, so I remove it and expose to the OEM printhead carriage. Look at all those crazy things the customer trying to keep those tubes together. Again, we decide which side is up and which side is down. Wow, what a struggle. We disconnect all the dampers so the tube can go through the drag chain. On the left side, we push a rope through the drag chain. Then we put all the tubes together and they use a cable tie all the tubes to the rope. Then I can pull the rope and all the tubes will go through the drag chain. We're going to install the drag chain on this front bar. You don't have to install it here. You can install on the top bar or anywhere else. I just use this front bar as example because I think that this front bar works well with the customer's casing. And this is an adapter for the OEM printed carriage if you want to install on the front bar. We're not going to use the original end from the drag chain. So this is the end of drag chain just snap on, and you can see it's a series of holes, and there will be one hole already made on the OEM casing. So those just for you to adjust the distance of the drag chain from the carriage. You want to keep the drag chain parallel to the movement. We're going to use a tight screw. Of course, the link to the screw is on the list in the description. However, if you have a tie screw somewhere, it's just a regular tie screw from Epson. Then we're going to drill a hole to secure the second hole. And this drill bit is important. I'm going to use the same drill bit later. And if you need this drill bit, again, I'm going to put it on the list. This drill bit can drill through plastic and metals, and is exactly the hole that you can use for both Epson OEM tie screw and the machine screw. But by the way, the tie screw is the one that you put it on the plastic. If you install on the plastic, you need a tie screw. If you need to install on metal, you need a machine screw. Now we need to decide where to put the bottom end. So we move it back and forth, make sure the printhead can touch both ends. Then we decide where to put the end of the drag chain. On the bottom of the drag chain, you're going to have the openings. So right now I'm marking up the openings so I can put a holder there to stabilize the drag chain. You're going to see later where I mark. This is the bracket that go underneath the drag chain, and I'm going to insert it in there. That's where I marked where the opening is so I can insert this bracket into the drag chain. Now I'm marking on the bottom end where those three holes are. You don't need to screw on all three holes. You just need one screw there. With the same drill bit, now I'm going to drill through the metal. That hole was for install the end. And now I take the drag chain away and I'm going to put the bracket there. And remember, I mark where each bracket should be. So now I mark the center point of the bracket. At the center point, there's a hole there already made. I made two more holes, and now I can use the machine screw to install the two brackets. Now I lay the drag chain on top brackets, insert into brackets, and install the last screw, machine screw. Now I need to readjust the parallelism of the drag chain, make sure the chain is installed straight. And reinstall all the dampers and you're ready to go. I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at the bchtechnologies.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.